Next question is from Solomon Roskin. How would you train clients who do not work out on their own?
This is a great follow-up question to that question, because right now it's going through my head as I'm remembering trainers who had struggled with re-signs and coming to me and telling me, like, you know, oh, I can't get them to follow the meal plan. Oh, they're not going to re-sign with me. They can't handle the training, all this stuff. And it's a very similar thing here, right? Like what we were just talking about with the macros and then the nutrition, that also falls into like the exercise thing. And this is something that took me years before I started to really piece this together too. Again, as a trainer, I see this client, I put them on a meal plan. I have this elaborate, you know, program that I designed for them for the next 6 months that I want them to follow. And the reality of it is a majority of people can't stick to any of it, can't stick to none of it. And, you know, and my attitude kind of was with that is like, oh, they're just not serious enough. I'll just keep going until I find another client who is serious enough. But that what I wasn't doing was improving my job as a trainer and finding out, okay, how can I start to change these behaviors in these people? And what I'm currently doing right now obviously isn't working, because more than half of them aren't sticking with me or aren't staying with fitness long term. And a lot of that is how much that I was prescribing to them. So if there's somebody who doesn't only works out when they work out with me, well, that's probably because I'm expecting them to do these training sessions that look like my training sessions, that are overly complicated, that I'm pushing the shit out of them and it's hard. And they're like, fuck that. The only reason why I do this is because you're yelling at me and you're pushing me through this. And that was a big mistake. And this is where I began to start to prescribe walking and prescribe yoga classes and prescribe
like two exercises.
Yes, prescribe a mobility drill. Yeah. We just talked earlier about mobility and stuff. This is another example of that. So I've got a client who I train 3 days a week, and I'm trying to get them to do some things on their own outside of it. And instead of asking them to do that leg session that I just did with them and they walked out crippled and were sweating and in agony, I'm not going to ask them to try and do that on Sunday, because they're not going to. The only reason why they're doing it now is because they paid for me to do it to them. But I would do things like, hey, you know, the handcuff to rotation mobility drill, we need to be doing that as much as possible. So let's set a goal this week that the 2 days that you don't see me, you know, I need you to spend, you know, two times in the day, spend 10 minutes doing that. Can we commit to that? And get them to commit to these things that I know if they do that, they will feel a difference. I'll even see it in their movement. And then when I see them on their day, I can follow up.
Because they do it.
Right.
Do you remember the workouts that you gave clients to do on their own when you first became a trainer?
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah.
I would be the most elaborate. It was like a full-on MAPS program.
Taking like 2 hours to do.
Yeah. Oh, I know you hired me because you don't know how to work out and you've never done this before and you need help. Oh, by the way, here's your workouts you can do on your own. This should take you about, you know, 90 minutes to do. And if you have any questions, go online, look up. It's insane. It's absolutely insane. You're 100% right, Adam. It's like, give them things that you know that they'll do on their own. And sometimes I actually had a client, this is no joke now, I had a client that was so resistant. One of my favorite success stories, she was the most unhealthy person I've ever met in my entire life. I've talked about her before.
Coke drinker?
Yeah, I hope she doesn't listen to this podcast. She didn't drink water. I mean, that's how unhealthy she drank soda. That's how she got her fluids. And my goal was to get her to eat to change her nutrition. And you know where I had to start? This is what I did. I started by saying, can you add, you know, a serving of vegetables to your day? No. And I told her, I said, it has to be something that you're going to do. This has to be realistic. So be honest with me. And luckily she was honest. So I said, be honest with me if you think you're not going to do this or that it's unlikely. So I'm like, can you add one serving of vegetables every single day? No. Can you add one serving of vegetables 3 days a week? No. One day a week? No. One piece of broccoli? No. Can you read a nutrition book? No. Can you read one page from one nutrition book to start with once a week? Yes. That's where we started. Wow. Literally, we started, I'd give her a page to read, she would read it, I'd train her, and we'd talk about it.
Yeah.
Now, slowly, you know what that turned into over the years? Slowly, it turned into completely changed behaviors, completely changed nutrition. But it was a really, really slow process. Because you give someone a bunch of stuff that they're not going to do, it's as good as nothing.
You're a new trainer. That's like such a lost cause in your mind. You're like, no.
Totally.
Right. Abandoned ship.
Have I shared the colored sticker thing that I used to do? So I used to.
Yeah, I love this one.
Yeah, so I used to go to like your staple center or staple, you know, whatever, local staples or whatever you guys got over in your area with office supply stuff. And they have these like little.
Office Max.
Yeah, right. These little circle colored circles that are stickers. And I would, you know, pick again a couple, either exercise, and it could be as simple as this, like 10 squats.
OK,
Okay, that's it. Or, you know, three handcuff with rotations, like the most basic, simple things. Or someone like DeSalle's lady, he's talking about, drink a glass of water when you, and I would tell them, okay, I want one on the refrigerator, one on your bathroom mirror, one next to the TV. And I'd give them these like strategic spots in their house that I know that they're going to go by at least once or twice or three times a day. And I'd say, when you see this sticker, do your 10 squats. When you see that sticker, do this. And it makes it kind of fun and challenging. And let's be honest, probably they didn't do it every single time, but it, at least it was there as a reminder. And I know they were doing more than what they were doing before because I had set all these little reminders. And you start setting simple little tasks and goals like that, and then you can build on that. And I think that was probably the number one mistake that I made, and most of my trainers that worked for me for many years make, is, you know, sometimes we forget, like, these people that are hiring us, where their starting point is and what is like overwhelming to them. And they're never going to admit it to you, by the way, either. They're never going to be like, oh, yo, Adam, that's way too much work for me. I can't do that.
All going to be like, oh, yeah, I could do all that.
Yeah, exactly. They're going to say that. But then if you're having a hard time with compliance, or they're not working out on their own, they're not doing these things, start with very, very basic behaviors, you know, and that could be going for walks. It could be squatting your body weight 10 times. It could be holding a plank for 1 minute. It could be doing the combat stretch for 30 seconds. I mean, start small, create the behaviors, build upon that, and that applies both for macronutrients and for exercise.